the singing of God Bless America.
Justice
bishops, priests, and religious. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The first joyful mystery. Annunciation. The angel Gabriel greets Mary with the title, full of grace. He then tells Mary, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. No one can rejoice more than I do at every step the people of this great country take to preserve the union, establish good order and government, and to render the nation happy at home and respectable abroad. No country upon earth ever had it more in its power to attain these blessings than United America. Wondrously, strange then, and much to be regretted indeed, would it be, were we to neglect the means and to depart from the road which Providence has pointed us so plainly. I cannot believe it will ever come to pass. The great governor of the universe has led us too long and too far on the road to happiness and glory to forsake us in the midst of it. By folly and improper conduct, proceeding from a variety of causes, we may now and then get bewildered. But I hope and trust that there is good sense and virtue enough left recover the right path before we shall not entirely be lost. George Washington, June 1788. We pray for the presidency of the United States of America. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our the blood of Jesus over Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, California, Colorado, Connecticut, Delaware, Florida, and Georgia. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
joyful mystery, the Visitation. Having said yes to God's plan, Mary then went with haste to visit her cousin Elizabeth, who the angel Gabriel said was in her sixth month of pregnancy. She remained there for 3 months before returning home. It may be the will of heaven that America shall suffer calamities, still more wasting and distresses, yet more dreadful. If this is to be the case, it will have the good effect, at least. It will inspire us with many virtues, which we have not, and correct many errors, follies, and vices, which threaten to disturb, dishonor, and destroy us. The furnace of affliction produces refinement in states as well as individuals, and the new governments we are assuming in every part will require a purification from our vices and an augmentation of our virtues, or there will be no blessings. But I submit all my hopes and fears to an overruling providence in which struggles of a great people have almost always ended in the establishment of liberty. Such a people are spoken of with admiration by all future ages. Their souls glow with the gratitude for the virtue of self-denial of their forefathers. They consider them as patterns for their own conduct on similar occasions and are continually pointing them out to the reverence and imitation of their children. These are the glorious effects of patriotism and virtue. These are the rewards annexed to the faithful discharge of that great and honorable duty, fidelity to our country. I pray to God that the fair character I have described may be that of America to the latest ages. James Iredell, May 1778. We pray for the Senate and House of Representatives of the United States of America. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on civil freedom, and political and social happiness which mankind now enjoys. In proportion as the genuine effects of Christianity are diminished in any nation, either through unbelief or the corruption of its doctrines or the neglect of its institutions, in the same proportion will the people of that nation recede from the blessings of genuine freedom and approximate the miseries of complete despotism. All efforts to destroy the foundations of our holy religion ultimately tend to the subversion also of our political freedom and happiness. Whenever the pillars of Christianity shall be overthrown, our present republican forms of government and all blessings which flow from them must fall with them. Jedediah Morse, 1799. We pray for the office of the governors of the United States of America. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We plead for the blood of Jesus over New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. Soldiers, let us humble ourselves before the Lord our God, asking through Christ the forgiveness of our sins, beseeching the aid of the God of our forefathers in the defense of our homes and our liberties, thanking him for his past blessings, and imploring their continuance upon our cause and our people. Knowing that intercessory prayer is our mightiest weapon and the supreme call for all Christians today, I pleadingly urge our people everywhere to pray. Believing that prayer is the greatest contribution that our people can make in this critical hour, I humbly urge that we take time to pray, to really pray. Let there be prayer at sunup, at noonday, at sundown, at midnight, all through the day. Let us pray for our children, our youth, our aged, our pastors, our homes. Let us pray for the churches. Let us pray for ourselves that we may not lose the word concern out of our Christian vocabulary. Let us pray for our nation. Let us pray for those who have never known Jesus Christ and his redeeming love, for moral forces everywhere, for our national leaders. Let prayer be our passion. Let prayer be our practice. General Robert E. Lee, 1863. We pray for all county and municipal officers of the United States of America. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We plead for the blood of Jesus over South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed seeking the grace to root out from our hearts all trace of darkness and all that holds us back from walking in the full freedom of the children of God. As Christ is our great model for all that inner freedom which enables us to do the right, let us turn to him with confidence that we too may follow him in the fullness of spiritual freedom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, victor over sin and death. Jesus, source of light and hope. Jesus, fullness of truth and mystery. Jesus, teacher of seeking hearts. Jesus, healer of body and soul. Jesus, bringer of mercy and justice. Jesus, who humble the heart and mind. Jesus, release of captives. Jesus, voice against violence. Jesus, courage for the lowly, downtrodden. Jesus, origin of all authority and power. Jesus, true lawgiver. Jesus, unity of order and passion. Jesus, freedom of the spirit. Jesus, obedient son of the Father. For the freedom to love. For the freedom to believe. For the freedom to hope. For the freedom to worship. For the freedom to serve in charity. For the freedom to care for the suffering. For the freedom to comfort the sick. For the freedom to feed the hungry. For the freedom to shelter the homeless. For the freedom to proclaim the gospel. For the freedom to walk in chastity. For the freedom to live in peace. For the freedom to work in good conscience. For the freedom to stand in solidarity. For the freedom to seek justice. For the freedom to reject sin. For the freedom to reject coercion. For the freedom to reject falsehood. For the freedom to reject evil temptations. For the freedom to reject injustice. O God, who gave one origin to all peoples,